friends, now we are going to practice some positive sentences in the simple present tense. The next question is going to be, how do we write a positive sentence using the simple present tense? Next, I'm going to say, how do we make a positive sentence in the simple present tense? For short form, I will just use SPT, isn't it? So here I'm going to give you an answer. To write a positive sentence, we use the following formula. What is that formula? Subject plus present tense verb plus object. Now I have taught you pronouns. What are those pronouns like? I, we, you, they. Then we have a chair, a table. Then we have like he, she, it, and names like Prasad and so on. Now let us use subject as I. Here present tense verb is going to be teach. What is the object? English. The formula is subject plus present tense verb plus object. Now, you might have studied maths or mathematics. There also we have formulas. Now, for example, a square plus b square plus c square, and so it goes, isn't it? In the same way, we have a formula for this also. When we use the correct formula, you're going to get the correct answer. If you don't use the correct formula, then it's going to be very wrong. In the same case, here also it's going to be the same thing. You have to use subject plus present tense verb plus object when you do a simple present tense. Okay, now let's move on to the next one. We go to college. Next, you play cricket. They sing songs. Okay, here we are going to use the plural subject. Doctors operate patients. Here he writes letters. She stitches clothes. It guards the house. Then say, Radha cooks biryani. These are all positive sentences which a person does it, or which a person can do. They are all called positive sentences, or in grammar we also call them as affirmative sentences. We call them as positive or affirmative sentences. Okay. Now over here, you need to be a little more careful when we are using plurals. Plurals don't add s or es to the verbs. Here you see, I have not added any s or es over here to these verbs. But for singulars, must add s or es to the verbs only in positive sentences of the simple present tense. This you need to be careful when we are learning these things. Now, for example, I tell you, I teach English. I go to college. I play cricket. I sing songs. I operate patients. I write. Here we should not use S. I write letters. I stitch clothes. I guard the house. I cook biryani. Here we have used plural subjects. Now we have to use singular subject. Okay. Radha teaches English. When you are using Radha, you have to add ES over here, because it is a singular thing. Radha teaches English. Radha goes to college. Radha plays cricket. Radha sings songs. Radha operates patients. Radha writes letters. Radha stitches clothes. Radha guards the house. Radha cooks biryani. Okay? You need to be careful with these two. When you are talking about I, we, you, they, or any plural subject, we should not add any S or ES to the verbs. But when we are talking about singular subjects like he, she, it, or any other singular subject, we have to add S or ES. There you need to be a little more careful. He drives cars. Second one, she travels by air. Third one is, I spend wisely. Fourth one, they care for children. Fifth one, computers work fast. Sixth one, churches open on Sundays. Seventh one, aeroplanes run on petrol. Eighth one, she conducts English classes. Ninth one, oil floats on water. Tenth one, mean tastes bitter. 11th one, girls gossip a lot. 12th one, trains halt at junctions. 13th one, she commits mistakes. 14th one, we go on holidays. 15th one, they count money. 16th one, vehicles carry passengers. 17th one, Radha travels by air. 18th one, the earth rotates around the sun. 19th one, honey tastes sweet. 20th one, stars shine brightly. Here you have, you will see, singulars are using S. I told you that for the positive sentences, when we talk about singulars, we have to add an S or AS to the positive sentences. Here in these 20 sentences, you'll see he drives cars. This is a singular. She travels by air, singular. I spend wisely. This will come under plural. They care for children. This is also plural. Computers work fast, plural. Churches open on Sundays, plural. Aeroplanes run on petrol, plural. She conducts English classes, singular. Oil floats on water. Now, oil, it is an uncountable noun because we cannot count oil, one oil, two oil, three oil. So, it is an uncountable noun. So, we take it under as a singular form. So, oil floats on water, singular. Neem tastes bitter. Even neem comes under non-countable nouns. So, we have to take it as a singular. Girls gossip a lot, plural. Trains halt at junctions, plural. She commits mistakes, singular. We go on holidays, plural. They count money, plural. Vehicles carry passengers, plural. Radha travels by air, singular. The earth rotates around the sun. This is singular. Honey tastes sweet. This is also uncountable noun. It will come under singular. Stars shine brightly, plural. So you need to remember that. For singulars, we have to add an S or ES to the present tense verbs. For plurals, we shouldn't add S or ES to those present tense verbs. You just keep practicing these sentences, and with the examples that I have given you, you can also add another 20 or 40 or 60, whatever it may be, till you are confident with the positive sentences. Friends, you may subscribe to my channel in YouTube. To subscribe, please press here. Follow me on Twitter by clicking here. Want to follow me on Facebook? Click here to like my page.